Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I am going to show you how to save and export a diagram in the Blazor Diagram component. You will see how to save and load a diagram as a string and file stream. I will also show how to export a diagram page in different file formats. First, I will open an existing Blazor WebAssembly app, which has the Blazor Diagram component with a simple flowchart. These are the nodes and connectors created for designing the flowchart. Follow the videos attached in the description below to know how to create a node and different types of node shapes, and how to create and customize connectors. If you want to know how to create this Blazor app and add Syncfusion components to it, refer to the video linked in the card above. I will run this application to show the initial output. See the diagram canvas rendered with defined flowchart. Now, I will show you how to save and load the diagram. A diagram can be saved in two ways, using string and file stream. First, let's see how to save the diagram in a string format and load the diagram using the string variable. I am going to use two buttons to demonstrate save and load. I import the button's namespace and add two buttons to the page with appropriate content and click event. Using the save button, I will save the diagram as a string. And using load button, I load the diagram using the save string variable. To access the diagram component methods while saving and loading, I create an instance for the diagram component and add a reference to it using the @ref property. To maintain state persistence, I modify the nodes and connectors properties using the @bind attribute. I then declare a string variable named data. I define the event handler saveDiagram. And within it, save the diagram as a string using the saveDiagram method. Here, the diagram is saved in a string format. Next, I define the loadDiagram event handler. And load the diagram with the saved string data using the loadDiagram method. I save the current diagram by clicking the Save button. Here, I debug the application to show you how the diagram saves as a string. You can see the diagram is retrieved in a string format in the variable data. I continue running the application. To demonstrate the state persistence, I modify the diagram by changing position of a node in the flowchart. Notice the offset values of the node have been changed. Now, I can load the previous diagram by clicking the load button. Let me debug and show you how the diagram loads with the previously saved string data. You can see the diagram is getting loaded with the previously saved string data. I continue running the application. The diagram is loaded with saved string data. Similarly, I can save and load a diagram using a file stream. Let me first show how to save the diagram as a file stream. To do that, I need to use JavaScript function saveDiagram to save the file and getDiagramFileName to get the file name to load the saved file. The save and load action also requires save as and loadFile C# methods to save and load the file stream. So, I referred the JavaScript and C# methods in this application. To access the JavaScript function in C# methods, I need to use the JS interoperability. Therefore, let me import the Microsoft JS interop namespace. I also create an instance for the JavaScript runtime with a name, JS Runtime. I need to name the downloaded file with an appropriate name. So I add a span tag with an ID, diagram name, and content, diagram component, to save the diagram file in the name of diagram component. As I do not want to display this span tag on UI, I set its display to none. Next, I define a method downloadDiagram, which accepts a string parameter. Inside the method, I save the current diagram by calling saveDiagram method. And assigning it to the variable data. To download the diagram as a file, I make a call to the saveAs method, defined in the fileutil class. By passing the JavaScript runtime object, string formatted data and the file name. To trigger this download diagram method, upon clicking the save button, I declare a string variable, file name. Inside the save diagram event handler, I comment out the existing code and obtain the file name required for downloading by invoking the get diagram file name JavaScript method. Then, I assign it to the variable file name and call the download diagram method by passing this file name as a parameter. When I click the save button, the diagram is saved as a JSON file. Next, I will show how to load a diagram using this saved file stream. To do that, let me declare a string variable, extension type, and assign JSON as its value. To upload the JSON file from the downloaded location, I am going to add the Syncfusion uploader component. So, I import the Syncfusion Blazor inputs namespace. Next, I add the Syncfusion uploader component with the properties, ID, allowed extension, and so on. Here, I have defined the onUploadStart event, with the event handler, onUploadFile selected. This event will be triggered when a file upload is started. To handle save and remove operations in the uploader, I define the UploadAsyncSettings tag with appropriate properties. To access the uploader component methods while uploading the file, I create an instance for the uploader component and add a reference to it using the @ref property. As I do not want to display the file uploader component on UI, I set the display property to none for the respective CSS class. Even though I made the uploader component hidden, I need to trigger its click event to open the file explorer to upload the JSON file and load the diagram. So, I will bind the uploader's click event to the click event of load button. Inside the load diagram event handler, I comment out the existing code and call diagram's begin update method to ensure only JSON file types are uploaded by the uploader component. I set the extension type to JSON and call the click event of the uploader component by passing the JS runtime object. I call the endUpdate method as well. Once the uploader click event is triggered, a file will be selected for uploading, which triggers the onUploadStart event. So, I define the onUploadFile selected event handler with the uploading event args argument. This argument has the details of the currently uploaded file. I will check if the current file is of JSON type. If so, I will load the JSON file by calling the loadFile method with the parameters JS runtime object and file data. Using the returned value JSON, I load the diagram by calling the loadDiagram method. Finally, I call the uploader's clearAllAsync method and clear the file list. Now, I modify the diagram by changing the position of a node. To load the diagram using the previously downloaded file stream, I click the Load button. The File Explorer opens and I upload the JSON file. You can see the diagram loaded using the downloaded JSON file. Next, I will show you how to export a diagram. The Syncfusion Blazor diagram supports exporting the diagram in different file formats. They are JPEG, PNG, and SVG. Now, I will show you how to export the diagram in PNG format. I will add one more button with the content, Export, and click Event with the event handler, Export PNG. I define the event handler. Within it, I create an instance for the Diagram Export Settings class. Then, I export the diagram to PNG format using the Export Async method. When I click the export button, a file in PNG format is exported. Similarly, you can export files in PDF format also. Refer to the documentation link attached in the description for more details on exporting. Like exporting, you can also print a Blazor diagram. Printing can be achieved using the printAsync method. In this video, you have seen how to save and load the diagram as a string and a file stream. You have also seen how to export the page in different file formats. If you would like to see a working example, you can download one from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also provided a link where you can see if you qualify for a free license key to use all our Blazor products through our community license. If you found this video useful, please like the video and subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching.